Hi, my name is Livi Crowell. I am an art education major and an artist. I specialize in oil paintings, portraiture, paintings just kind of in general. I also do ceramics. It's pretty fun, pretty cool. A lot of digital art too and graphic design. I'm actually certified in that. Heck yeah. I'm in my senior year, so I'm getting pretty close to teaching. And I love spreading art and showing art and stuff like that. This is an oil picture painting that I'm working on right now. It is Harry Styles, because I'm in love with him and I love everything about him. So I'm still working on this guy. Love him. He has a flowy shirt. Very, you know, mix of feminine and masculine, which is, I love that as a queer artist. This is a portrait of my best friend. You know, I really wanted to represent things that I found beautiful in people that aren't usually seen in, like, fancy oil paintings that I had ever seen before. So, like, tattoos, piercings, being queer in general is never really seen in media, kind of. So it was also a big accomplishment whenever this got into the McMaster Gallery and got seen by, like, everybody. I think that's an accomplishment at all that my first oil painting got into my first ever exhibition thing. This is on a gesso board. It's a panel. Pretty cool. I like when my things have absolutely no texture and are just going very smooth. So this is already prepped with gesso and stuff like that. And then I just went for it. Background's acrylic. This painting is still drying and it's 3 months old. I use a lot of paint. I just love showing beauty that's never really seen in art. I enjoy it. This is another piece that I did. This is on a piece of wood. Just a piece of wood. I was inspired by the birth of Venus. So I kind of took her and then made her really cool looking, in my opinion. I made my own egg tempera. It's just egg, water, some other powders and stuff that you all mix together. And some people in my class thought it was kind of gross, but I thought it was really cool. So this is a screen print that I did on fabric, and this is the only one that survived because the fabric was so thin, and I did like 5-6 layers on it. So every piece of fabric broke before this guy. This is the only one that survived. And I love it so much. It's this cool lady who's bald, because I think bald ladies are beautiful, and I was bald before, and I just think it's fun and cool. It was supposed to go on a giant welded thing, but that thing curved from the heat and nothing would lay on it, so I just went to fabric. For a while I didn't know like why I was doing art. It was just kind of something I was good at, so I went to college to do it. So I was kind of in a weird place for a hot minute of not knowing why I'm doing it, not knowing what major I was going to go into. I was studio for a while. I didn't really enjoy it. I was just like, I don't know why I'm making any of this. Yeah, it's good. Yeah, I guess I'm proud of it, but there's no reason for me to make this. I don't really care. So I talked to one of my drawing professors. I was like, I don't know why I'm in my major. I don't seem to care about this. I don't really have a passion for this. And he was like, well, you just got to find it because you shouldn't waste your talents if you don't even care about what you're doing. Think about my art. I don't really own a lot of it. Every time I make a piece, I just kind of give it away or it is for somebody. I don't really make art for myself. I usually make it for other people and for their enjoyment. That's kind of why I do it. I like seeing the happiness it can bring someone if when they're gifted a painting or something like that. I don't know. I just think that's really cool versus like keeping it for myself. But if I'm really, really proud of a piece like these, I will keep them and hoard them until the day I die.